Lifted or leveled? What's the difference and which one is right for you? In this video, we will be exploring the similarities and differences between leveling kits and lift kits. From installation to ride height, we're going to go through all the differences between these two suspension upgrades to help you find the right one for your truck. Let's start by taking a look at leveling kits. The name is self-explanatory as it levels your truck. Most trucks come from the factory with what is called a rake. This is where the rear of the truck sits higher than the front. A leveling kit eliminates any rake your truck has, leaving it sitting level at all times. It does this by lifting the front of your truck 1 to 2 inches. This is great if you need just a little extra ground clearance or if you run a plow and want to prevent your suspension from sagging. On top of giving you more ground clearance, leveling kits also allow you to run slightly larger tires. Sizing is going to be dependent on the make and model of your truck, but generally you can run tires that are 1 inch taller than stock without running into any issues. Ride quality should not be affected either, as most quality leveling kits do not affect the way your truck rides. If anything, they'll increase the way it rides. So, if this is something you're worried about, make sure that you're investing in a good quality leveling kit. BDS, ProRide, and Zone are all very reputable brands that make high quality leveling kits, which you can find at sdwheel.com. There are two main types of leveling kits, spacer kits and suspension kits. Spacer kits are exactly what they sound like. They are 1 to 2 inch spacers that are installed on top of your truck's existing suspension. This type of leveling kit is typically cheaper than the alternative and is typically easy to install. You simply remove your factory struts and bolt the spacer to the upper mount of your strut, then reinstall your factory struts and you're good to go. Spacer kits are going to be cheaper than the suspension kits as well, with most costing under $250. Suspension kits replace the front shock and sometimes the entire strut assembly on your truck. This kit will require more assembly than a spacer kit, as you will likely need to assemble the front struts, set the ride height if your kit comes with adjustable shocks, and preload your springs. However, suspension kits can increase your suspension travel and improve ride quality, especially if you're replacing old and worn out shocks. Suspension kits are more expensive than spacer kits, with most ranging from $500 to $1,000, but some of the really high-end kits can cost up to $2,000. If leveling your truck doesn't provide the clearance or look you need, it's time to start looking at lift kits. Lift kits can range from 2 to 10 plus inches. Typically, people looking to daily drive their truck stick to the 2 to 6 inch range, but there's always the possibility of a bigger lift if that's what you're after. The kit that's right for you really depends on how much ground clearance you want and what size wheels and tires you plan on running. Lift kits are generally quite a bit more expensive than leveling kits, with some costing over $5,000. When it comes to lift kits, quality is everything. Lift kits will impact the ride and stability of your truck even more than a leveling kit will. Ride quality will be dependent on the quality of lift kit you buy, but a lot of quality kits will ride similar to OEM suspension, with some high-end kits even riding better than factory suspension. Stability, on the other hand, will be dependent on how big of a lift kit you buy. The taller the truck, the less stable it will be. Typically, you'll get used to the way your truck handles with its new suspension shortly after installing the lift kit, but it is always a good idea to take it easy for the first day or two after performing any suspension modifications. The installation process on lift kits is a lot more involved than leveling kits, with some kits requiring you to replace almost every major suspension component, and some even require the modification of existing components. Unless you're handy with a wrench and have experience replacing or upgrading your suspension, we recommend leaving the installation to the professionals. A lot of lift kits offer optional add-ons that include control arms, bushings, shocks, track bars, and even more. Lifting your truck will change the geometry of your suspension, and new suspension components that are meant to be ran with the lift kit you installed can help correct this. Why is the geometry of your suspension important? Well, for starters, an aftermarket upper control arm can help keep your caster and camber within an acceptable range. This means that the shop will be able to properly align your truck and prevent any premature tire wear. In addition to this, proper suspension geometry can help prevent premature ball joint wear. Whether or not you need additional aftermarket suspension components with your lift kit depends on a lot of factors, from suspension travel, to shock length, to the type of lift kit you have. There's a lot of math involved in determining what you need for additional suspension components, but a good rule of thumb is, if they are offered with your lift kit, they're probably worth the investment. The right suspension really varies from person to person. Do you want to keep a stock look but fit slightly more aggressive wheels and tires? Then a leveling kit would probably be a good option for you. If you're looking for more ground clearance for off-roading, you're probably going to want to look at a 2 to 4 inch lift kit. Or maybe you want to build a show truck. Then you're probably going to want to look at a 6 8, or even 10-inch lift. When buying suspension, make sure that you take both aesthetics and functionality into consideration. And once you do that, you can head on over to SD Wheel and buy the perfect suspension upgrade for your truck today.